when storage units are abandoned in the Great White North.
Great.
The treasures within go up for auction.
Nine.
Yeah.
Coming up.
My goal is to obtain one locker.
Who let Mary Poppins in here?
Shut up.
Whoa.
Stop casting all of that.
800, 8.5.
Time to show the kid how it's done.
Sold.
Oh.
This is part of the job I don't like.
1900.
Yeah.
Some of them go for a lot of money.
Ugh. I'm done with this. Let me clean this up.
This is a game, and I don't lose.
We're going all in.
It's a dog-eat-dog business.
Don't tell me can't, because I can, and don't tell me don't, because I will.
To Orangeville today, and used to be a prosperous little farming community. Where there's history, there's sometimes valuable locker loot.
There's a lot of seniors here, small antique furniture. Love it. We got a fat stack, let's spend it.
Try to hold them and fold them.
That's right. We've got the cash today, and we're hoping that Orangeville's got the gold.
I've spent 40 years at the poker tables, and the same rules apply to these auctions. So watch and learn. What I've always told you about when you're playing cards, you're that newbie on the table. You're the fresh fish.
I'm also trying to portray something that they don't know.
Right now, you're the fish. This is a master class, and I'm the master.
I brought enough money today that I could probably buy every unit, but that sounds like a lot of work, so why don't we just buy the best?
And if I don't bring anything home, at least I get to mess with some heads.
After coming up empty my first time out, I am not going home without a locker.
When you're leaving the auction without having bought anything, it's the worst feeling in the world. People are looking at you. They're not taking you seriously as a buyer, almost as a joke. And I hate that feeling. Just get me out of here. I'm done with this today.
Probably won't be expecting to see Ursula today.
That woman gets on my nerves.
My Cindy is used to being the queen of the auction. Anyone threatens her throne, watch out.
Yeah, look at this.
There's Cindy. She is a fierce buyer, but I'm going to prove to her that I can be just as fierce. Hey, guys.
Look who's here. Holy shit.
Okay, before we get started, there's a few rules. Do not enter the locker. Do not touch anything. Have a look. Move out of the way. The terms of the auction are cash. Is everybody ready?
Yeah!
All right, let's go.
Who let Mary Poppins in here?
Shut up. What do you want? I just had my hair done.
What a piece of shit.
Clearly, there's no pride of ownership in here.
No,
must
no pride.
Must have got a big load of crap.
If the owner don't care about their stuff, why should I?
Not for us today.
We're not going to be going on this.
Are you seeing what I see?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I'm so excited. Yes.
I have a good feeling about this one. I think there's a lot of things that might be hidden in there that people are not seeing.
There's something in there, all right. It's called garbage. Even I know it's a total waste of space.
I'm thinking I might go for this one.
Okay, everybody had a look. How much here? Somebody got $100? 50.
If this is the cream of the crop, we should just go home now.
$10.
You gotta be brain dead to bid on this.
10, 20.
$10.
I rest my case.
10, a bit around 20, no $20 here, 10, a bit around 20. How about 15? 10, a bit around 15, get a $15 anywhere.
I got this.
Anywhere 10, a bit around 15, get a 15, 15 anywhere. Sold. Ursula buys $10.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
They always say you remember your first and that's a virgin locker. Try moving that garbage dump home, loser.
Your first time shouldn't be with someone this ugly.
Feel free to take notes, because that's how it's done.
This is worse than the first one.
Not worth the gas money to get here.
Ursula, your locker's calling.
There's the bike she's going to have to ride home on, because her car's going to be full of garbage.
Best locker of the day.
Do I detect sarcasm?
That's junk.
There's going to be something in there. And I can't wait to rub their faces in it when I find it.
Everybody's had a look. $10, right?
$10.
10, 15, 15, 20, 20. We got 20. 5.
Here comes the big spender.
30.
30.
30, but now 30, 5 to 5, 30, but now 5, 3, 5 to 5, 30, but now 5, 5. Sold, $30.
Woo! Number again. Two, people. Count them.
Two times nothing is nothing.
You can't go wrong at these prices. You gotta make a profit.
She's like a serial dater, but she only dates losers.
Oh, God. Why should I ruin a good outfit sifting through a $10 locker? This table needs fixing some side tables. Probably get about, you know, $100 for the pair. 10 times my investment. In your face. Housekeeping? Another dresser worth not much, maybe 25 bucks. More money, honey. Mice feces. Ah! Picnic, anyone? It's actually in good condition. Probably $15. Wow, this is gross. Okay, so here we have a cooler. From the weight, I can feel something's in there, so I guess here goes nothing. Oh my gosh. I just found someone's lunch and I nearly lost mine. Maggots and all, dehydrated. This is part of the job I don't like. I'm done with this. That's just gross. I'm a fashionista, not a dumpster diver.
Is it upside down TV? That looks like it's in rough shape.
No, 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 no. It's the painting we can't see, but
yeah, but it hasn't been treated well at all.
I know. That's right. Just because they don't think it's valuable don't mean it's not valuable.
If that's the only item that is drawing us to it, why would we even?
This locker looks jam-packed. Definitely worth a bid.
There might be something, but it's not worth breaking the bank over.
I don't see anything other than a nice air conditioner in there.
I'm gonna pass on that.
Nothing. Looks like these farmers moved to greener pastures.
You know what? If it goes at the right price, that seems to be the theme today.
Okay, everybody had a look here. $500 there, five to go, five.
Yeah.
Thank you. Now 600.
And 500 is definitely not the right price.
600. 600. Yeah. T-Wag. Six and a half, six and a half, now seven.
Yeah.
Now a half.
Eight.
800, eight and a half.
Time to show the kid how it's done.
Eight, but now eight and a half.
You got it.
And now nine.
I thought we were done.
850? Are you high?
Nine, yeah. Now nine, now half.
You
nine
got
and
it.
A half, now 10.
No.
10. 10.
Too much for too little.
Sold. $950.
OMG.
Now we got it.
There goes my inheritance.
Now you load it.
And my back.
Last one, maggots. I really hope this isn't another science experiment. Golf clubs, 50 bucks. Brand new printer, probably about 40 bucks. You have some miscellaneous tools here, probably another 20, 30 bucks. There's crystal. That's an easy 15 bucks. Let's see what's under here. Who said I didn't have any balls, eh? Ah, we have some cowboy hats. This is worth about 30 bucks, this cowboy hat. All in all, I paid $30 for this locker. I definitely made my money back. Well, I didn't get rich, but I didn't go broke, and the day's still young.
That unit looks gone through. See the boxes.
But you can see by the open boxes that the locker's been ransacked. Not a good sign.
Everybody knows you don't bid for sloppy seconds. But we don't have to tell her that.
You know what? This one's a nice one. I think I'm in on this. You know what? Why not?
Another pile of garbage.
You guys got any money left? I'm not buying it, but let's see if I can dump this loser locker on one of these suckers.
You guys are missing out on all the lockers, I'm telling you, man. This is the one.
This is not the one.
Just ignore this guy. Listen to me. This is a good unit, man. You're gonna buy one? This is the one.
That washer looks pretty new.
Okay, now see those empty boxes? They've gone through this stuff and taken it out. See what I'm saying?
When a unit's gotten the once over, it's over.
Ready to go?
Yes.
100, two, two. Two, but down three, but it goes three, 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 but it goes three.
Yep.
300, 350.
Hey, Ursula, what do you say we go for a ride?
Yeah. 400. $500.
Yes.
And 600.
Yeah.
607.
Yes.
Seven, a bit down
yeah.
Eight, a bit down nine.
Going up.
Nine, would you go nine?
Nine.
Now 10.
This is where I get off.
Now 10. Nine, a bit down 10. Now 10. 10. Sold. $900. Ursula buys.
Kiss your cash goodbye, because it ain't coming back.
How do you like that, ladies and gentlemen?
That was good for me. Got a smoke?
Everybody's been in your boxes already. Whoa! Stock, pack, and all of that.
That's my girl. When my Cindy smells profit, watch out, boys.
I think I see a fridge.
Got some appliances, the bedroom furniture is in here, the whole house is in here.
Oh, look at those mattresses. Oh, my God.
All right, look at here. Where else can you buy milk boxes full of rocks?
The person who collects these kind of rocks is professionally involved with them.
How do you get professionally involved with rocks?
No, people collect rocks. That's amethyst.
There was a lot of amethyst rocks in there. That stash is worth cash. And that's just what's up front. Wow, 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 wow. Now that Queen Elizabeth has blown her stock, this one's mine.
All right, $100, $200, $300, $500, $600, $700, $800.
Time to step up my game.
$900, $11, $12, $13, $14, $15, $17, $18, $18.5. Now,
she wants that box of rocks? Let her pay for it.
Now, $1,900.
Yeah.
Getting up there.
$19.5 to go half. Now $2,000.
Yeah.
And 50.
This is high, even for us.
$2,050 did you want in, Roy? Why not? Never mind. $2,050.
Yeah, you better not ask me.
$2,100. $21.5. 21 to 21.5 and a half, yes,
yeah.
Or no. $1.5.
Time to stop.
$2,200 to you to go to.
They're all yours, Bottle Blondie.
Sold. $2,150.
Cindy. All right. Yeah, that's how it's done. Take note, Ursula. That's how you buy quality.
My work here is done. I didn't win any auctions, but I still took those suckers to the poorhouse.
It was a good day here in Orangeville. Love it. But you can't bend down.
What do you think you're here for?
Not to make any money, that's for sure.
This lamp is $5.
Hold on, let's see if the lamp works. Okay, it doesn't work.
Try again.
$1.
See that? You guys look for stuff that's signed. This could be $100. Here's a nice table. Now look, see how it's bolted together, not glued?
Yeah.
This has got a bit of age to it. That's $50. Hey, Yana, we can save Yana $500.
These dresses are shit. I'm not giving her these dresses.
It might be her size.
No. If I show this sketchy dress to my fiance, the wedding's off.
This is nice.
Right. For the bride of Frankenstein.
Of course, everything's there. Worn once. Doesn't even have to be cleaned.
No.
That's a $100 bill. Maybe $200. Looks like a 50s kitchen set. Sink. Oh, it's a three-piecer.
There's kids' toys in here.
Yeah, but they all add up. This is gonna be $150 anyone's money. That sums up our locker.
Here's us, and here's breaking even. Is there some sort of clock in here?
He said it was a lamp. That's a cook. Wait a minute.
Oh, wow. I know nothing about cuckoo clocks.
Well, some of them go for a lot of money.
It's got potential.
I gotta say, this clock showed up
right on time.
I'm gonna take the clock. You can load the truck.
What? I hate you.
Oh, whoa. Yeah. Wow. We could get $50 for that, no problem.
Ah, what did you find?
Old 45s.
Rock on. $25? Yeah,
sure.
You sell the whole set? Well, sure.
It's too bad. There's a lot of nice antique furniture in here, but it's in pretty rough shape. Ugh, fur coat.
Something jump out at you?
I thought maybe. It's a rabbit, but not a real one.
Wouldn't be the first time we found a family pet. Or worse.
Oh,
unfortunately,
God.
I think someone was an artist. Not a very good one.
Oh, man.
Oh, look at this. It says cash.
Open it.
It's cash receipts.
Oh, boo. Could be money.
Nails?
Screws, like we kind of got screwed in this unit.
This little vanity.
Yeah?
You'll probably get about $350, $400. These are carpenter's chests.
A little rough shape, but people like refinishing them. And there is absolutely nothing in here. I think we could probably get $150 for that piece. Wow. Oh, I'm saving the best for last. Amethyst. I think we might want to get these checked out. Yeah, very nice.
Now everything is riding on those rocks.
I love rock and roll.
I'm hoping to find out the value of our little cuckoo clock. So we're bringing it to Willem at his antique clock store. He'll be able to tell us just how cuckoo our locker purchase was. Willem.
Hey, Paul, how are you?
How you doing?
Good, 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 thanks.
This is Bogart. Nice to meet you. My trusty assistant.
Is this the time for truth? Do you want to take a look at this clock?
Sure. They started building cuckoo clocks in the mid-1700s.
That was back when Dad was in high school.
If you had one of those, you'd have a pretty valuable clock.
Please be from the 1700s.
You got a clock that's probably made in the 60s, 70s.
1860s?
No. I would say probably about the 1970s. You've got a few issues. You need some parts. This would have played music, it would have cuckooed, and it would have told you the time.
Would have. That means it doesn't do it now.
What I see here right now, unless you really want to spend the money, it wouldn't be worth it. This would only be good for parts.
Would you actually even give us $20 for this?
I'm being nice to you.
Today was not a good day for us, but our time will come. At least I made $20.
I get half of that.
This is my third locker. If I got played on this one, I might as well give up the game.
Okay, we have a washer here. For the pair, you probably get about $250. We have a brand name watch here, probably $150. This bench, I probably get about, you know, $40 for it. People keep important things in strong boxes, right? Nothing. This was a bust. Son of a gun. Who says you can't work in heels? Look at that, hey? We have some porcelain dolls, and these are old.
This one's creepy.
Check that out. It's ugly and beautiful at the same time. Probably $150.
I'm gonna turn these dolls into dollars.
Okay, we have a space heater here. If it's working, $40-$50 for that. Okay, so we have a suitcase here. Feels full. My luck, it's full of clothes. Let's take a look. Oh my. Oh my God. Oh. For real? Come on. So you have a plethora of unique toys in here. I think this belonged to Cindy and Rick.
Not getting these appraised. Let's see what else here.
Looks like a horse whip. I really hope it's an antique and something that doesn't go with that suitcase that I found earlier.
If this whip is worth something, I'll get the last laugh. But I gotta take it to a whipologist to find out.
Giddy up! Somebody clean this up!
We went to see Samantha at the rock store to see if our rocks were worth their weight in gold.
So what can I do for you today?
Well, we found these rocks in a storage unit, and we don't know too much about them, but we're really excited to find out what they are.
Okay. Got some rose quartz. You have some amethyst. Usually people that come in this store with a lot of rocks are getting me to grade specimens. These pieces are not specimens. unfortunately. So if you take a look around the store, you'll see, like that piece in the window over there, you'll see the quartz growing.
Right.
You're at in perfect point.
Right.
And your quartz isn't doing that.
Right.
If you had this amount of weight in that variety of stone,
this would be worth a couple $1,000s.
Wow.
The rose quartz here is probably worth the most money. You know, a piece like this, I could give you maybe $45.
45, eh? Damn, I thought they were gonna be worth money.
Honestly, we get crushed by these stones.
Sometimes you spend big, but you lose even bigger.
This whip could really put me ahead of the pack for once, so I'm heading to a saddlery to find out what it's worth. And bonus, I get to wear equestrian chic.
Hi, are you Jeff?
Hey, you must be Ursula.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Well, I brought you this.
So, that's the riding crop. It's a very old riding crop. What makes it special is Manila canewood, actual fish bone. On the exterior, cotton weave, hand-stitched through, cut out leather for the handle. Finished it off beautifully with a sterling silver cap. This looks like Latin message here, kind of a spiritual message in honor of the owner.
The only sign that I'm looking for is a dollar sign.
Time period, we're talking 1800s.
Hmm.
Back in that day also, it was a status symbol.
Okay. Status schmatis. Let's talk dinero, caballero.
What's it worth?
It's in decent condition for its age. You're looking at $2,500.
Wow! Holy crap! That's awesome! Not oh my bad. Goodness, I have to give you a hug for that! Cheers. You just made my month. That's fantastic. That's, thank you so much.
That's a pretty good find.
Awesome. I can't believe how great it is to be on top. Roy, Cindy, I am the queen. I just whipped the competition.
Ursula had beginner's luck. Her antique riding crop landed her in the winner's circle. Paul and Bogart went cuckoo, buying a trashy timepiece that wasn't worth the time of day. Rick and Cindy had a rocky day, saddled with a ton of heavy stones at rock-bottom prices. And Roy went home empty-handed, but with fond memories of messing with everyone's head.
I would recommend to you, potentially, to receive a crystal treatment that could maybe turn the tides.
Oh.
This is our Jupiter grid, associated with the planet of Jupiter. Jupiter represents prosperity and growth. Go ahead and make your way into the grid. Perfect. So we have a rose quartz for your heart. So again, the crystals on your body are again going to help to amplify your energetic field. I'm going to place some eye pillows over your eyes. And on top of the eye pillow, I'm going to be placing a piece of quartz, which is going to amplify and open your third eye.
Do people actually pay for this?
Take a nice deep inhale. And let's exhale through the mouth.
I'm sorry, I'm getting a cramp in my left shoulder blade.
That's okay.
Ow. That's weird.
Yeah, the grid does things like that. So it's okay. Just
now
allow
what does
it.
What that mean?
Well, you know, there's resistances that we hold in our bodies.
Okay.
So sometimes when we're in treatment, these things will be activated.
Pretty relaxed right now.
Oh, my legs have been so sore. Like I was experiencing a lot of pain in my legs.
Yeah, well, yeah.
And my bum wasn't.